Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ. Thanks for taking this time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're really going to like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Did you know that you don't have to use the HSA provider that your company provides for you? That's right. In fact, you can choose any HSA provider as long as you have a high deductible health plan. You can sign up with any company that provides HSAs. So this gives you the option to potentially save on fees and maybe get better features once you're actually able to look at multiple providers and see which features and which options work best for you. Now, if you do receive an initial deposit from your employer for using whichever HSA platform that they've already agreed to work with, then of course you want to make sure you get that deposit. That's free money that's going to your account. But every dollar after that, you can actually choose which HSA provider you would like to use. And Lively is one such HSA provider that you have the option to work with. Lively is an HSA provider, which allows you to save money that you can then put towards your medical expenses. But they also partner with TD Ameritrade so that you can use their investment account to actually invest your HSA dollars. And TD Ameritrade is one of the most popular trading platforms. So you're going to get a lot of features and access to a lot of research that you may not have access to based on the investment company that maybe your HSA provider or your employer has their relationship with. So how does this work? How are you actually able to use a different HSA provider, and how are you able to make deposits? So just like with any other savings account or any other investment account, you can make direct deposits from your paycheck, you can transfer from your bank account, or you can transfer funds from another HSA provider. So if you already have an HSA account, the one that you maybe set up with your employer, you can actually transfer the funds from that account over to Lively or over to another HSA provider that you choose. So Lively may be a great option for you if the provider that you currently have has a lot of fees, or really any fees at all, because Lively doesn't charge any fees for their accounts. And one of the features that really stands out to me is the option to be able to save your receipts for your medical expenses whenever you've made a payment. That way you can actually reimburse yourself years down the road. So if you've heard of the FIRE community, the Financial Independence Retire Early, many people in this community, the strategy that they use is to, instead of using your actual HSA cash to pay for your medical expenses, they would use maybe a cashback rewards card and then use their regular income to pay off that credit card for their normal medical expenses today. And then 10, 20, maybe 30 years down the road, after they've allowed their money to compound over years and years, possibly multiple decades, then you get the reimbursement from your HSA provider for the medical expenses that you had prior. So for example, if you had a $500 expense that you would normally use your HSA account to pay for, meaning you would spend $500 of pre-tax income, pre-tax dollars to pay for that expense, instead of using your HSA account now, if you allow that $500 to grow over a 30-year period, compounding at an average of about 8%, which is what the stock market has averaged over the past 90 years, then 30 years from now, that $500 could turn into $5,000. And so now you have $5,000 that is tax-free that you can use towards medical expenses, and you can reimburse yourself for the payment that you made 30 years ago for $500. And that's basically $500 tax-free that you're giving back to yourself, and you can use that $500 for anything technically, but you're basically reimbursing yourself for a fee that you've already paid. And in addition, the other $4,500 that you have in that account, you can still use that $4,500 to pay for any other medical expenses that you may have. So if you're in retirement, of course you're older, you're more than likely have more medical expenses in the future than you would now, depending on your age. And so being able to have that $500 grow into $5,000, reimburse yourself the $500 that you already paid in the past, and now you have another $4,500 that you can use tax-free to pay for any medical expenses that you have now once you're in retirement. And so because Lively gives you the option to save medical receipts that you're actually gonna reimburse yourself for later, this is a great feature. And it allows you a great place to save that information, and you don't really have to worry about where your physical receipt is. Now, of course, you may want to create your own digital backups by using maybe a company like Dropbox, or maybe having an external hard drive where you save information like that. But Lively will have that information saved for you, so you don't have to keep those physical copies of the receipt. Now, going back to the fees that I mentioned, there are no fees with the Lively account. There is no minimum balance in order to open an account, and there is no minimum balance in order for you to use the investment options with your HSA account. Now, with some HSA accounts or HSA providers, they do require you to have a minimum balance before you can use the investment option. And so, just using my own employer as an example, we use HSA Bank. And with HSA Bank, you have to have a minimum of $1,000 in your cash account before you will actually be able to activate the investment account. And within the investment option, you actually have two options. You have TD Ameritrade, the same that Lively uses. And then you also have another company where you can actually access mutual funds. Now, personally, those mutual funds, they have very high expense ratios. So that's one reason why I chose to use TD Ameritrade instead of that. But I also use TD Ameritrade for my personal trading. And so this was already a platform that I'm used to. And I can easily connect my HSA account to my regular trading account so that I can view those investment options all from one account. And when I checked the HSA Bank website, there's actually a $2.50 monthly charge if you have a cash balance that's less than $3,000. And like I mentioned with my employer, we actually don't have that fee. And so that means either my employer is paying the fee, or that fee is waived by going through the employer versus going through HSA Bank by yourself. Now, just like most HSA providers, they do provide you with a debit card. That way you can use your cash balance to pay for any medical expenses directly through the account instead of doing reimbursements. So whether you're using cash now to pay for it, or if you're using the cash in the future, once you've sold off investments and you want to transfer that cash back to your HSA provider's saving account, you can use this debit card to pay for those expenses. As far as interest rates for the actual savings account, they are lower than your typical online high yield savings account. So I don't really think of this as a savings account for me personally. I actually put any money that I have in the HSA account and I automatically transfer it to the investment account so I can start investing those dollars and compound over time. So with Lively, if you have less than $2,500 in your account, you get a 0.25% interest rate on that cash. If you have between $2,500 and $4,999, you get 0.35% interest rate. If you have between $5,000 and $14,999 of cash, you didn't get a whopping 0.45% interest rate. And anything over $15,000 in cash, you get 0.60% interest on your cash. So this gives you even more motivation to not keep a lot of money in the actual cash in the savings account and immediately put that money into the investment account. That way your funds can grow along with the stock market, which has historically given us between 8 to 10% gains throughout its history. And if you just look at last year in 2019, the stock market as a whole gained 28%. So if you had your money in a total stock market index fund or ETF, then you would have gained 28% if you had that money in at the beginning of the year versus only getting maybe 0.25% or as high as 0.60% by having that cash in the HSA savings account. Overall, Lively seems to be a really great option as an HSA provider and as an option to invest your account by connecting it through a TD Ameritrade account. This combination makes it one of the best options out there for you to actually use for your health savings account. So let me know in the comments below if you're a current Lively user, or if after watching this video, Lively is an option for you that you're thinking about using for your health savings account. And let us know which provider you're currently using, and if you think it's better, or if you think Lively is actually a better option for you. All right, thanks for watching this video. If you're not currently a part of the Mobile Money Nation, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. Guys, have a great day.